now. His indecision is hitting him. Yeah, yeah. Hey, hey! How are we going? Woo! Oh, good, eh? Yeah, no, I turned over in extracts. Yeah. I know. We should write in and ask them, why didn't you say about the rock? Yeah, cheers, mate. Neil. All right. Remember, don't follow me if it looks bad. Indeed. Good luck, man. I'll see you at the finish. Sandbar there. One. Oh, shit. Yeah, I got it. Cheers, mate. How you going, mate? Come good so far. Haven't been able to catch you that quickly, which is always a good sign. Oh yeah. No worries. Yeah. Just telling the bloke behind, and that's what the top guys do sometimes. They deliberately lead you into a lion's den. But when I'm in survival mode, that's the furthest from my mind. The water's not powerful today, so if you've got troubles, just slow up, grab a tree, and pull yourself around there. Probably wanted to go through there. Ah, no! So, yeah, that's right. Correct channel, guys, well done. It's okay, just slow it down here. I give my bum steer. Coming through. Lucky mate. Oh, unlucky, Anji. How you doing? You're allowed to here, it's a tough one. Push straight through. Pull the branch over your head. You should be right straight ahead. Alright, doing good, mate. Yeah, I reckon. Well, judging by nobody being behind us, I think we're doing better than a lot of people. Yeah, couple. I got YouTube videos of the last three descents down here. So people use my videos to train, and then I have to tell them, sorry mate, I went the wrong way. But yeah, jump that on the right. Yeah, straight over. Dan. All that, you can do that too. Alright, I'm just gonna push you around a bit and help you out. Accidentally, but there we go. Yeah, sorry, I forget, I jump logs. But it's probably not the best thing in a longer boat like that. But you did the right thing. You had a look at it first. Yeah. Nah, it's tough to turn that thing at the best of times. The what, sorry? The boats, yeah, well there are longers. So you're in I think it's what they call a normal kayak K1 length. Then they... Oh, sorry. there's about 45, maybe 35 minutes from jimpeting, and we haven't hit jimpeting yet, so we've got at least 45 to go. The entire TiTrees today is an hour and 20, or maybe an hour and 10 if we're pushing. So I have been recording for 27 minutes. So we're approaching halfway in the trees. Yeah, indeed. I think that's jimpeting, yeah, which is around about halfway, so probably in the next 15 or 20 minutes. You changing, are you? Oh, yeah, nice one. You're going the whole way. You! Nice. Well, before I turned over in extracts earlier, I'd done the last 12 years without capsizing. So, yeah, it was my first swim. Glen Avon, yeah. The one with the tree at the bottom? Yeah. Oh mate, that tree's been there for so many years and yet everyone always hits it. It's like, surely you'd learn. But we have rain, and that means tomorrow... Yeah, that's it, yeah, open your mouth. Yeah, oh damn. We do have a support crew. My dad and I are doing it in singles. We do have a support crew, but I've just stopped with at the spot and I haven't jumped out yet. So, because I jumped out of extracts already. my last stop was at the orchard back at the start of the TiTrees, and I just get a carbo shot into me and eat some food and keep going. Bloody hell, this pool is not nice. This is number 13, yeah. So I was put on grid 13 for my 13th Avon, and then I capsized. Go figure. I think they were saying something to me. Yep. Oh mate, the first big bit of the drop, you're thinking, oh, it's like northern weir, right? Yeah? Nah. you know the history behind extracts? It's a man-made weir, obviously, but it started off with no rocks. So it started off as a 3-meter vertical drop. So when they first built it, it was not a paddleable, you know, negotiable chute. Then they put the rocks on it in the late 80s, and it was supposed to be quite dangerous because they didn't put a chute down it. And I mean, I think they're bullshitting because the river is never really high enough to shoot that rapid. But then after that, they put pipes, they put rubber pipes across the river and you could slide down the pipes. They did that so that low levels would be negotiable. But that was a big environmental thing. And come over to the left here if you want some deep water. Further left, right on the bank here. Yeah.
Phew!
Yeah, so they took out the pipes a few years later. I did 1 year with the pipes to 04. And then 05, they'd taken the pipes out and they'd made a chute on the right hand side. So similar to the chute they've now made in the middle, they made a really dodgy one. Middle one, yeah. Hey, cheers guys!
Yoo-hoo!
Yeah, so you would have aimed for that post on the left of the two posts, yeah. They were telling us beforehand to come down to the right of that post, just to the right of it, and angle over to the left. And you look at that and you're like, hang on, but that's not in the chute, you know, like, that's so that you don't hit the huge drop at the top, like you're saying. So I did that, hit the huge drop, that wasn't the problem, came down, the rocks were right at the end. Got me, shot me off to the side, and good point, yeah. So, I know, and like, what's the safety? You got safety crews there, and you've done your competency, so you know what to do. Why is it not safe for the guys who haven't actually paddled the race before? You know, I reckon it's probably more dangerous for me to do it because I haven't done a paddle safety competency course in 15 years, so. Yep. It's good, eh? Yes, if you're going slowly, you can wriggle.
Yeah.
But I attacked the damn thing. Came down fast and went over fast. I had a green double 515 in front of me, double plastic, and they got side on in the rapid, and they go, oh, who's at the top? Number 339, Terry Russell. Oh, he's doing a dance, waiting for these guys now. I'm sitting there going, boop, 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 just waiting, and only one boat I had to wait for though, so it wasn't too bad. Sometimes you have to wait, and then you just portage because it's faster. So at emus, I recommend that you portage emus because there's probably going to be a line of boats in front of you. If there's no line of boats, see 0.7 is when you can do emus comfortably. 0.6, I wouldn't attempt emus unless I wanted to fall out. So it's 0.65 right now. Emu falls, it's the first big thing tomorrow after the start. The start, actually, well, there's the super shoot, yeah. No. If you run around emus, you'll pretty much, I mean, that's the thing, if there are two or three boats holding you up, you'll be faster portaging. Yeah, it's as simple as that. Like, if you have to wait at the top of emus at all, the portage is maybe, or, you know, like 30 seconds to a minute slower than shooting the rapid. So you don't lose. And you just cut the corner of the bottom section, you shoot the big left-hand part of emus at the top, come all the way around, left, the scorpion's tail. Then you're in a pool. And there's a big beach on the right, sandy beach, you can just pull into the beach. You'll probably see all of us carrying as well. And that's it. So basically, if the river's clear, I'm going down. If it's not clear, simple as that. There's a beach, like that beach on the right, for example. You can pull out anywhere. Yeah, there is no... They keep telling you, hey guys, this is Jimpiting, by the way. That's Jimpiting Brook. I thought that was the last team changeover, but obviously not. It'll be a little bit further down, but very close now. So we have got approximately... Yeah? From the start of the TiTrees? Oh, okay, and that's at Wetherill, wasn't it? At the park there with the bridge? Yeah. Are you good, dude? No worries. That's all good. Because we got 12Ks of tea trees. So, do you remember what kilometre mark you were at when you entered the tea trees? Yeah. No worries. I think we got, like, maybe... 4 or 5Ks at the most. It's a bit hard, isn't it? It's mainly because downstream of Possil's Ford, there are tea trees, but there are more rocks. So Fossils forward is the end of the tea trees, you know, period, even if there are trees behind it, yeah. Because you're looking here going, well, there's no trees here. Now, oh, okay, second channel. Either one, but yeah, second's probably going to be easier. Yeah. Yep, yep, yep. If you got time, just watch that thing on the right there. You right? Sweet. Yep, yep. Woo! Woo! A hard left here, man. You want to cut left. That's the channel. That's the channel, boys. Woo! Hey, hang and follow them. When in doubt, head to the right. How you going? Yeah, you're doing along, doing all right. Been behind you for a
while.
You got round it?
No, I
haven't. Now the entrance to the channel was on the right back there to get into the channel. Very difficult. I made it, but I haven't made it the two previous times. How are you going backwards, mate? Good-o. You'll be right. Plenty of room there. Travelling right so far today, mate? Yeah? Alright, so that's all good. That's the way it ought to be. Nice one. You mind if I lead down here, dear? Cheers. Not too far to the finish now. You see a rammed earth house on the left? It's 2.8 kilometres to the finish. really shallow pools. Oh, thought we'd seen the last of them. Keeps raining, eh? Can't be lower, that's for sure. Funny, I could switch boats for the flat sections and then switch back to a hopper for the rapids. So the first year that I did it was the lowest ever, 2010. This. So this is now number 6, and this is my second hopper, so I've already broken one. We all got the main peak store there. They sponsored they got a whole pile of their employees doing it 1 year, doing 2010. They were doing a special women thing that year too, so they got a few of their women staff members to do it, and we were all training them. They were given wave hoppers as a first boat, this boat. So they were like, hey, we're going to learn how to paddle and then do the descent, all in a wave hopper. So we trained and trained and trained and did all of that, and then 2 of 8 of us finished. So, yeah, because it was so low, the first day just wiped out, I think, everybody except us two. And Adam and I, we got through, we were the last finishers down at Bayswater, and I was second last overall, 18 hours 16. And Adam holds the record now for the longest ever Avon descent, 18:31. He ended up 15 minutes back on grids, so he holds that record. I'm glad I don't have the record for the longest ever. But they extended the cutoffs as well, so it's not actually possible to get another 18-hour race unless they extend cutoffs again. So we didn't know that they were going to extend, and then as we got to Bells, they said, oh, you're still in the race. We were 10 minutes overdue, yeah? And then Middle Swan the same. We got to Middle Swan and thought, no, we're done. But they'd extended it and forgot to tell people. So we kept going just thinking, nuts to them, we're going to finish anyway. And we were okay. But then poor Dave Tupling, he got out at Bells, and they said to him, he got out at Wayunga. They said, no, you haven't made it. He got out. Got some sandwiches, sat around, and then someone sprinted up and said, no, they've extended the cutoffs, keep going. So he jumped back in and he missed the extended cutoff. So he was pretty mad because they didn't tell anybody and all this. But I think they probably shouldn't have extended the cutoffs to begin with. They said they wouldn't, and then they did. So. Yep. Low that year too. Yeah, definitely. Yep, 12 over. Do what you're told, but then they don't know what they're doing, so what are you supposed to do then, eh? Okay, back into it. No, it can't be that far now. We've been going for over an hour of TiTrees. Now, we think there's an hour 10 to an hour 20 of TiTrees, so this really is the last little bit before we get there. Now, look at all the boats stuck on the left. And guess where we're going? Not left. Early right, yeah. says that's a way too, yeah? It's a way, not the way. Plenty of space. Here we are, leatherheads. Yeah, gee, that came up quick. So this is leatherheads and then Cobbler Pool. Now I take the right hand side of the rapid here. Yeah, it's quite easy, but just make sure you take the right path. See where that bloke's stuck? That's what'll happen if you go left. Yeah. You got plenty of time to line it up first, so line it up correctly and then power through the rapid. You've got a left turn coming up down here. So line it up, take your time, middle of the river. low water, definitely. Yee-hoo! Making sure. No one told me it was going to be painful. They didn't tell me that. Hey, good luck, man. I'll see you up here somewhere, I'm sure.
Yeah.
No, you can just leave it here. We've got a support crew coming, so. Guys, good.
Excellent.
No
good
more cat
footage?
Sizes.
Good,
yeah, indeed. Thank you. Thanks so much. Awesome. Face forwards. Extra work tomorrow.
Thank you.
Woo. Good fun. How's your day?
Yeah.
Yeah, oh my. About 2J, I thought, hang on a minute, I suppose we can cover them. We can move these up to. Someone else can jump in there, I guess. Do you want to just kick my one? Just give it a drag, yeah, sweet. Nah. Yeah, true. Yeah. It's not like a running space down here. Yeah. It was nice of them to carry us, though. Yeah, about 2J, it starts to feel painful when you're like, oh, it's a little bit longer, isn't it? It's just a bit more from 2J, right? Just a little.
Never
oh mate, when you get to the gauge, yeah. Gauge, I thought, oh, a gauge now with just a tiny bit more.
Yeah.
No, huge long pull.
Keep going,
don't stop. Sort of like not recognisable. And then the pull up above the leatherheads here, I thought, oh yeah, we've still got a bit to go. Leatherheads. Sweet!
sort of like had a bit of a time lapse.